evening, members of council, ladies and gentlemen, staff. I see that we have quorum, and I call this regular meeting for the Town of Pelham Council for Monday, November 4th, 2013, to order. We will begin with an invocation led by Councillor Durley, followed by the singing of the national anthem led by Councillor Papp. All rise.
Dear God, who has given us grace to make our common goals unto thee, and who does promise that when two or more are gathered unto thy name, you will grant their requests. Lord, we supplicate your blessing upon this assembly. Fulfill now, O Lord, the petitions of thy servants as may be expected of them. Grant all in this council chambers the knowledge of trust, justice, and honor in all considerations placed before them. Provide us in this chamber, O Lord, strong minds and discerning spirits as we deliberate over the business of our town, that we move forever forward to ensure the Town of Pelham continues to be a vibrant, caring, and creative community. May God bless all in our community and grant us in this chamber the wisdom, will, and generosity to guide the Town of Pelham through the challenges and successes that lie ahead. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patron of, in all thy sons command, with glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, councillors. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Appreciate that. And also, Madam Treasurer is here as the acting CAO. Our CAO, unfortunately, is ill this evening. So thank you very much for stepping in. Appreciate that. The first item of business is the approval of the agenda. It's been moved by Councillor Durley, seconded by Councillor King, that the agenda for the November 4th, 2013 regular meeting of council be adopted. Are there any additions or amendments to the agenda? Councillor Clark.
Section 15 under new business. I have submitted my letter of resignation to the clerk as required by the Municipal Act.
New business is a letter of resignation. Okay, thank you. Is there a seconder for the adding that to the agenda? Councillor Ribiak. And we'll get to that issue at that time under 15 new business. All those in favor of adding that item? All those opposed? That is added. Any other additions or changes to the agenda? There being none, I call the question. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. Thank you, Councillor. The next item is disclosure of pecuniary interest and the general nature thereof. That is any conflicts of interest. Are there any conflicts to disclose? Nobody is declaring any conflicts. Can that be so noted in the minutes? Thank you. Now we move to hearing and presentations, delegations, and our regional councillors' report. First, we have a presentation by Inspector Jim McCafferty, and it says introduction. Please come up to the podium, and thank you for joining us this evening, Inspector.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor and members of City Council, my name is Inspector Jim McCafferty. I've recently been transferred to the Central Region, effective October 1st, which consists of Welland and the Pelham areas. And my purpose tonight is just to come and introduce myself to you and tell you briefly about myself and perhaps on a go-forward basis some of the plans. I've been with the service just short of 30 years. I have extensive operational experience, supervisor experience, and administrative service. Been to a number of different areas in the service. This is my second tour of the Welland area and Pelham area. I was here in 2002 in the criminal investigative branch, where I got a pretty good idea of the town, some of the areas, some of the challenges to it. And it's my pleasure to come back here again as the district commander in charge of the of policing operations for this area. I'll just tell you briefly, I do have a bit of a political pedigree in my family. My father served as the mayor of St. Catharines for 9 years. So I have a pretty good familiarity of what your job consists of and some of the challenges and some of the relationships with the policing services. So hopefully that'll assist me working with you. On a go-forward basis, I understand my predecessor had a good relationship with the town. Mm-hmm. It's my challenge to continue that operation, keep the communications open. I am available if required, if you need me to come to council for any issues. Perhaps on a go-forward basis, I would state that I'm just going to try to work with you to, if you have community issues which you think need to come to our attention, I'm here to work with you. And perhaps one thing I could stress, if there are issues your wards are bringing up to you, I would ask to perhaps ensure that they have already reported them to the police service so that we are aware and we can respond to it. Sometimes some of the wards believe we are aware of issues, but we're not necessarily aware that they are. So I stress it should be reported to us so we can put our resource to particular problems in your areas. So just shortly, that's who I am. That's kind of on a go-forward basis. I'm learning the area again, and I look forward to working with you. If you have any questions, I'm available to answer them.
Thank you very much, Inspector, and we certainly appreciate you introducing yourself to us. I wonder if members of council have any questions for our new inspector, in addition to welcoming him to our community. Councillor Clark.
Yes, through you, Mr. Mayor. Speeding has been a concern, was brought up when I was campaigning. It's brought up quite regularly. I believe Mr. Mantle's trying to set something up with the group here in town as well right now. I'm just wondering what provisions the police would have for helping us with our speeding issue here in the town of Pelham.
Well, we do have a specific unit which responds to, through you, Mr. Mayor, sorry. We do have a specific unit which responds specifically to traffic challenges throughout the region. There is expectations of the officers in this area to respond to traffic issues. If there are particular areas, I encourage them to be reported to us so that we can allocate resources to those particular areas. If there are areas where a number of accidents occur, we try to have our officers attend to those. But if there's particular areas that you think we should be addressing, please bring that forward.
Okay. One more.
Go ahead, Council.
Yeah, further to that, we, and I had this conversation with Mr. Mantle, we have, I guess, what's left of one of those speed indicator machines. As you drive up to it, it flashes your speed. Okay. Do those help?
Do they help?
Do they? Do you have? I'm catching you off guard here, but I mean, do they help? And where I'm running with that is, if they do, then perhaps that's something that we should look at, getting our machine back going and getting it out on a regular basis.
Well, I don't have any direct evidence, but I certainly would say that it makes me think twice when I'm going down particular roads when I see the speed I'm doing. I do actually look down, so I can't see the negative aspects of it. If it's any deterrent at all, I would encourage it to be used, but I don't have specific evidence that I could point to.
Okay, thank you for that. And I think just on that, occasionally either council or members of the community have made me aware, for instance, of some speeding issues. We've had the discussion here around the table of specific roadways, etc. In the past, what I've done is I've forwarded a letter to the inspector at the time asking for additional resources. Is that how you propose this type of relationship to continue? Is that what you're suggesting?
Mr. Mayor, I think that would probably be the best way to go. That way they come directly to me. I can ensure that there are officers assigned to those specific areas which would report back to me, and I could make you aware of any results that we have.
Okay. That's excellent. Thank you. So thank you for that, Councillor. Other questions for our inspector? Thank you very much, Inspector. We appreciate you making time to introduce yourself to all of Council. I know that you met with Mayor Sharp and I when you first started, and we appreciate that as well. And thank you for introducing yourself to the community. We look forward to working with you for many, many years. Thank you very much, Inspector. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Next, we have a delegation, and that is Mr. Tim Gretsch from Niagara Skydive Center. I think you have a presentation, and I don't know if you need some help with that.
I do.
There we go. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. And council may not be aware, we did bump Mr. Gretsch from the last council meeting because we had so many presentations. So I appreciate you making clearing your schedule and being able to be here this evening.
My pleasure.
So go ahead, sir.
Mr. Mayor, councilors, municipal staff, and neighbors, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Tim Greck, and I'm the owner of the Niagara Skydive Center, which recently relocated to the Welland Airport. And I've come to speak to you today to tell you a little bit about our company. A picture is worth a thousand words, so perhaps I should first show you what it is that we do. First, we'll talk a little bit about myself. I like to consider myself a local boy. I was raised in St. Catharines. I went to Niagara College. I have a degree in business. I started skydiving about 30 years ago. I have 5,500 skydives. I'm a commercial pilot, and I'm the sole owner of the Niagara Skydive Center, which has recently moved to the Welland Airport, or the Niagara Central Airport. Our corporate advantages are that we're in a great facility. We are 100% Canadian owned. Our aircraft are all owned and maintained here in Canada. We have very large facilities with large packing areas. We have multiple runways. We're within 2 hours of about 7 million people. We have full-time staff. We're open 7 days a week. We have some military experience, training some military personnel. And we currently operate, and we conduct about 5,000 to 7,000 skydives a year. And we're the only skydiving center in the world that has the opportunity to overfly Niagara Falls on every trip to altitude. We opened up in 2001 at the Dunnville Airport. We moved there, renovated the facilities. We operated quite successfully for 11 years. At the beginning of this year, the Dunnville Airport closed down and became a wind farm. So we negotiated a lease here at the Niagara Central Airport. We employ about 25 people. We won the 2011 Haldimand County Tourism Award. We opened up for business here at the Niagara Central Airport in May, and we've had a very successful first 4 months to our operation. Customers, employees, and employees are a very, very big part of our business. So I brought a little bit of statistical information to show you. First of all is our staff. We have staff accommodations at the airport. This is very common with skydiving centers. In fact, it's quite necessary. We require a very specific skill set for instructors and pilots. And since it's a seasonal business, we attract people from basically all over the world. So in our staff accommodations, we accommodate 18 staff, and they come from 12 different cities around the world. We typically bring in one or two people under the foreign workers, the temporary foreign workers program. This year we got a visa for a gentleman from Hungary and one from Russia, and our pilot moved here from Ottawa for the season. It's basically a six-month contract we do with each of those employees. As far as our customers are concerned, our customers once again come from a very wide variety of places. most of them, like I said, we're within 2 hours of 7 million people. Our two customers are primarily people who are going to jump by themselves and people who are going to do a tandem skydive. A tandem skydive is what you saw in the video. So these are people that have jumped solo. So we've had 192 visitors from 32 cities that have come here to jump by themselves. These statistics come directly from our waivers. So that's how we know where the people come from. And the only people we're counting are people who have actually signed the waiver. So those are people who actually took advantage of our services. Nobody ever comes skydiving alone. When you come skydiving, you usually bring a few people with you. You bring your wife, your kids, your friends to come and see you tick off one or two things off of your bucket list. So as far as solo skydiving is concerned, we've had 192 participants who did their first jump here from 32 cities around the world. The most popular way to skydive is tandems, and that's what you saw at the beginning of the during the video. We've had 1,181 people participate in our tandem skydiving program. They came from 95 cities from around the world. Mm-hmm. We have a great opportunity here with our move. We're much closer to Niagara Falls, so we've had a great opportunity in entering into some wonderful marketing experiences and partnerships with the hotels in Niagara Falls and the youth hostels. So it gives us an opportunity to grab people who are here visiting Canada to come to the Welland Airport and do a tandem skydive. And on the way to altitude, we circle Niagara Falls and they get to see the falls. It's a great marketing technique. These people come from all over the world. If you look around, we've got people from Australia, we've got people from Singapore, Finland. It's quite a wide variety. These people are coming to the region, and the only reason they're coming to the region and the municipality is to visit the Niagara Skydive Center. Our best estimates are that we would bring about 10,000 people a year into the region. Switch for me. Our most famous visitor to date has been Honorable David Onley, and he was here to meet with councillors Peter Papp, John Durley, Richard Rubiak, and Mayor Dave to review and recognize the town's accessibility playgrounds. It was quite a thrill to have such an honorable gentleman visit our facilities. They flew in a government airplane, which was very, very nice. He visited our facilities. He expressed some interest in coming back next summer to do a skydive with us. And he said he would do that only if Mayor Dave would actually jump at the same time.
I'll take this favor.
Put that money in a budget.
What we give back to the community.
If I can push.
Yeah, thanks, Councillor.
We bring a lot of business to an area. We certainly need the cooperation of all of our neighbors. So we like to do things that include our neighbors and thank our neighbors. The most notable thing that we've done since we've been here is on Labor Day weekend, we had a party, and that party was to thank the neighbors, the other users of the airports, the councils, and the commission for allowing us to operate in their community. We had about 120 people that had a sit-down meal. It was a pig roast. We had a band play, and then we did a firework display. And we put an ad in the local newspapers inviting our neighbors to come out and watch the firework display. We're hoping to turn this into, we've had a very positive feedback with that function, and we're looking to turn it into an annual event and making it bigger and better for next year. The fireworks seem to be quite a hit. Other things we do is we always get involved with local charities. As you can see, we made the front page of the Trib and the front page of the Standard for a fundraiser we did for the Julian School. They raised $10,000 in a day, and we donated all of the skydives for that function.
Wonderful.
If you want to know why we do it, this is why we do it.
That last gentleman that you saw was 90 years old. He jumped with us 2 weeks ago. I'd like to thank you for allowing us to operate in your community. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your presentation. We sincerely appreciate it, and thanks for coming to our community. Very, very interesting information. I wonder if members of council have any questions for our presenter, Councilor Ribiak, who also sits on the commission.
Thank you. Yes, and you saw me hard at work doing what we all do best. Thanks for the presentation. I wonder if you can describe briefly how commerce, business in Pelham might take advantage of those 10,000 visitors that you're bringing to the area, and how they might support you.
Well, the support that we would appreciate from council is first of all, you're welcoming our staff into the community, welcoming our customers into the community, and continuing to offer support when we deal with regional issues. As far as the commerce that we bring to the area, we bring about 10,000 people through the community. We've really concentrated our first year on building infrastructure. What's called the COPA organization, which is the Canadian Pilots and Owners Association, has a very strong chapter out at the airport, and they have they realize that we have to have a link between the airport and the communities. And what they've done is they have raised the money to donate a van, and that van will have the Niagara Regional Airport, or the Niagara Central Airport logos on it. And they're going to go out to the community, and they're going to get sponsors. And it's a nominal amount of money. And in exchange for that, they're going to have their logos put on the side of the van. And we're going to put together a brochure. And the brochure will tell all of our visitors what all the various eating establishments and other local attractions are. And when somebody comes into the airport, they will have the right to use this van. There'll be a GPS set up on the van so they can pick all their favorite spots. As a part of that is the development of this pamphlet that will talk about the four different communities that support the airport. And in there will be coupons for $5 off to go to such and such a place. And we will then make that available to our customers. Our customers do come with their own cars, and they come here to spend a lot of money. Yeah, an experience at Niagara Skydive, our lowest ticket item is $250 plus tax. Once you add in your video, you're looking at a better part of $500. So all the people that come to visit Niagara Skydive Center, they're here to spend money. It's an expensive activity. So that link of having the brochures that promote all of the local businesses will now create that link between the airport and the community.
Thank you.
Gratis of the COPA chapter right at the airport.
That's great. Thank you very much. Councilor Ribiak, anything? We certainly appreciate that that answer. Councilor Papp?
I'm in.
For which part, sir?
I have to tell you, I made a pact, and I shouldn't say this publicly, with a group of gentlemen that we're going to do this one way or the other. Yeah. But just what do you anticipate as far as, besides the infrastructure? I know Councilor Ribiak's done a great job with the commission. What are some of the future things you'd like to see happen besides that? What other things would you want to see happen at the airport, particularly with your business?
We're almost there with infrastructure. We have some challenges with the region, and we need your help with that. The airport is growing. It's the volume of people that are going through there is exponentially bigger or greater than it has been in the past. We have a flight school, the St. Catharines Flying Club, who has been a well-established flight school, have been in business for 60 or 70 years, is opening up at the airport within the next week or two. That'll be bringing a wonderful new opportunity for the region as far as learning to fly is concerned. And as of November 1st, which was, I guess, a couple of days ago, we now have a full-time mechanic at the airport as well. So we are certainly, the airport is growing. There is currently six hangars under construction, which it's sort of like a condominium corporation, where it's one big hangar that's divided into six, and then you buy a fractional ownership. Those hangars aren't even finished yet, and five of the six have been sold. As other airports close down, like the Dunville Airport, for example, because of windmills, we will see an influx of pilots coming to Welland. They're also closing the Buttonville Airport. And the Buttonville Airport houses probably 500 aircraft. So you certainly get a ripple effect where those airplanes are going to get displaced, and then, you know, the people that can afford to move it to Burlington, move it to Burlington, and then they push people out further. So, I mean, I think we've got a wonderful future there, but you've got a great facility on with a lot of land, which gives us great opportunity for growth.
Thank you. I think, Councillor Papp, I know that we've had the discussion at the Chamber of Commerce meetings, and I think it's also something that's sort of in the back of our mind as we look at our economic development strategy for the town, and maybe it's something that staff can add, or we can add to the action plans as we talk about economic development, some of the ideas that Mr. Gretsch has added. So thank you for raising that, Councillor. Anything further, any other questions?
I just wondered if you can articulate, if you can't, what sort of challenges at the region, what are you running into?
Some infrastructure issues as far as the increase with usage at the airport.
I see.
Our biggest challenge has been the septic system. The septic system was built back during World War II, and the facility housed hundreds of people actually lived there at the airport. The airport was underutilized for a number of years, and now that it's starting to be utilized again, the region is looking at that septic system, and the septic system is completely functional, but because of its age, they're not being as flexible as we'd like them to, or as accommodating, or as helpful as we'd like them to. So you could be very helpful with that.
Well, and I...
yeah.
I know I've had the discussion with some of the staff at the region already, and we'll continue to do so. So
that's the type of thing you can do to help us out. There's phenomenal opportunities at the airport as far as just tourism is concerned. We've really linked ourselves into Niagara Falls, and that's a great opportunity for bringing people into the region.
Okay, anything further? Councillor Clark.
Just a little sunshine. That's a very, very nice little airport, and I'm glad to see that it's being taken advantage of and used with more future growth to it, too. I think that's really, really good.
Okay, thank you, Councillor.
Well, we invite you all to come out. The neighbors were very social. We welcome the neighbors to come out. We've spent a significant amount of money upgrading the facilities. We have a picnic area. I see some of our neighbors out here that come out on a regular basis with their children to watch skydiving. There'll be increased flights there now with the flight school. And we're a very inclusive organization. It's a lot of fun being out there, seeing people realize their dreams. And you're always welcome to come out and sit and have a picnic and ask questions. It's got a great energy to it, and that's what I was trying to demonstrate with the video. So,
thank you very much for your presentation
thank
and for sharing some of that energy and that vitality. Thank you very much, and best of luck to you in your next season next year.
Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you again. I do have a motion here that we receive the presentation, and it has been moved by Councillor Papp, seconded by Councillor Ribiak, that the information presented by Mr. Tim Gretsch regarding the Niagara Skydive Centre be received. All those in favour? Any opposed? That motion is carried. Thanks again for your presentation. And I think in terms of working together, Councillor Ribiak, we look forward to you continuing to update Council on activities at the airport, and again, I think it's something that we should look at in terms of our economic development strategies. So thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you. Now we have a report from Regional Councillor Brian Beatty. Thank you for joining us this evening, and thank you for adhering to our changes in the procedure bylaw, which asks for your report in advance. So thank you for that. So all of Council had a chance to look at that in
good.
Advance.
Good. I will confess I was a few hours late, but it's a case where the volunteer appreciation night was on the Wednesday evening.
Yes.
And by the way, commendations to that was first class event. And during the presentation in particular of the music, the young people there was really well received. Now my format here is going to be to try and help you with the issue of time management, etc. So I will not be reading the report. I have purchased a web building software and blog site software for hopefully early next year, where the details of this can get posted for citizens who are interested. What I will do is make commentary on only really key issues, in particular ones that might affect Pelham, and an update. Now, I've just talked with the clerk earlier. I'll bring a written update for her for the record of things that might have transpired at the council meeting itself. Because of this format, you will be receiving this report after the council meeting, as before, depending on the 3-week cycle. Sometimes you get it before, sometimes after. So The only one I want to make comment on is integrated community planning, because it does indirectly affect your community. The IMS facility proposed for Lincoln, the town of Lincoln, that was referred back to staff to go through and in terms of some justification of the need for such a facility. That obviously is important to this town because of the potential road traffic that would be created if that facility were put into operation. At council itself, you should be aware that one of your citizens made a presentation regarding the Short Hills deer hunt, Ms. Zavitz, and also a person from St. Catharines. I believe the presentation was made here as well.
Yes.
And council overwhelmingly supported that direction in terms of public interest, in terms of safety, in supporting her request to have that ban basically put on that hunt for this year and subsequent years. We did have a significant discussion on the cultural investment program. Mr. Mayor, I'm going to need your help as the budget chair here, because I believe that while we didn't respond to that, we did refer to the budget review committee.
They did, yeah.
For consideration. That would be a new form of incentive that we haven't currently done. We've done them in other areas, et cetera, like CIPs, for example, but it's something that is being considered through this year's budget. As with yourself, there's been a concern for the number of times we now have had 7 out of 13 meetings this year gone over the deadline of 11 o'clock. Last year it was 9 out of 15, and sometimes that's extending past 1 o'clock in the morning. Don't do very good business at that time. But so a motion was passed to have our curfew be 10:30 with a possible extension of half an hour only to 11 o'clock. While that was passed and will be followed through, the concern is not so much the deadline, in my opinion, it's the process. What do you do to streamline things? Mm-hmm. And my personal feeling is you cut back one speaker only to one time speaking to an issue, and rather than the 10-minute limit, maybe down to five, mm-hmm. to try and get that work done. Otherwise, we're looking at other days in the week to try and put a meeting in for just-in-time issues, and that, I think, will be problematic. And the last thing that you need to be aware of, there was an attempt to try and have a reconsideration of the monies that come from Provincial Offenses Act monies currently being directed towards the police reserve fund for capital. There was an attempt to try and have that reconsidered and put that towards their ongoing operating budget, which would bring them technically down to our guidance limit for budget. That didn't receive anywhere near the two-thirds majority that it required. So that's my report, more succinct than normal, and I'll be prepared to answer any questions that you have.
Thank you. Councilor Beatty, I wondered if you wanted to just touch on, unless you wanted me to do it, the issue regarding a resident from the town talking about the Hamlet policies in ICP, the first item there. Members of council, we had a presentation, and it was a public meeting regarding the Hamlet policies. Council will recall that it's some policies that we received here locally. There was some concern from a particular resident that owns property in Ridgeville that the Hamlet area, or what one might think would be a Hamlet area in the Ridgeville area surrounding at the intersection of Effingham and Cambro, is not actually considered a Hamlet. The response from regional staff as to why that wasn't there is because it's not in our official plan. And if it were in our official plan, then it would go into this Hamlet policy and be covered. North Pelham, as I understand it, is covered by this Hamlet policy, and I think it's the only Hamlet in Pelham that is covered. And then there's obviously policies for the urban areas of Fawn Hill and Fenwick. So I think it's something that it's sort of his request was to deal with it here. I thought it was a part of our official plan, and it may have been touched on in a previous official plan, but it's not in the approved one. So maybe it's something that we really do want to look at. And I don't know what's required from a planning perspective, but maybe we should get a report on that, so that individual owns property on the it's Mr. Rutina. He owns property on the northwest corner there, and we have those shops in that area, but there's no special policies that cover them. So I think that was one of the important features that came out of that public meeting. The region indicated that they were very, very willing to work with town staff on this and council, but they were looking to council for a lead. So maybe it's something that we can look into further and start some action on. I'm not asking to make a decision now, but obviously, but just that it's something that I think we should consider. It was brought forward. So if that's okay, we'll maybe ask staff to come forward with a report on that and talk to Mr. Rutina and see if there's a possibility to add this to the AOP or not. I don't know whether it is or isn't. Okay.
Ms. Tapsoli? Actually, I discussed with the property owner and in Bridgeville area. We have three hamlets, you know, that is considered as the established urban area in our official plan. And although we have five names as in, you know, hamlets that in Pelham area, the reason that there are just three of them is that future growth. They haven't seen it, and all would be that kind of you know, urban area that we could consider that established urban you know, boundary. So seems there is some possibilities to be add to those three hamlets, but with the you know, growth, you know, just as we look into. It's not just if you want to do it or not. We need to see, you know, how many people are going to be, you know, living in those areas that consider that those hamlets as an urban area or not. So I think it is something that we can look into, but the possibility is based on the future of growth in the area.
Okay, that's helpful, and I appreciate that. But so if perhaps with council's indulgence is something that we can look into and come back with our future planning report on. Thank you. Any questions for Councilor Beatty?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Through you to Councilor Beatty. Under Public Health and Social Services Committee, you mentioned they received a report on the Niagara Housing Stability Plan. I'm just wondering, will any of that impact on Pelham directly and indirectly to Pelham residents that may want to take advantage of opportunities in the stability plan in municipalities other than Pelham?
Yeah, this is a result of a significant government cutback initially about a year ago, and then they did some reconsideration. I think we got back about 60%, I believe, of what the funding had been before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Actually, what's happened is that the fund has been managed very conservatively, I think. Over the course of this last year, we've stretched the dollars further than what we thought we were going to be able to do at the outset. And it's come down to, in particular, there have been some housing providers where we've given assistance in terms of upgrading some of their facilities, beds, for example, in terms of that. So specific for the Pelham facilities, I would have to inquire, but it is widespread across not only the regionally owned properties, but on the other properties as well throughout Niagara.
Just as a follow-up, the new facility that you are building in Welland on Fitch Street, is what's the status of that?
We're not building. Sorry, I was thinking of the long-term care facility.
Yeah,
sorry.
No,
we are building the one on Fitch Street. Yes.
Yeah. What's the status on that? Is it it's supposed to be ready soon, or?
That's my understanding, and it's a LEED project, very highly environmentally sensitive in terms of energy conservation. I don't have an end time. I don't sit on the NRH in terms of that, but I can get the information for you.
Just curious. Some folks have been asking me, and I'm not really sure, but perhaps I'll contact one of the regional councilors who sit on that committee, and they might be able to tell me. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. I'm trying to think of who sits on that. I know that Councilor D'Angela.
I believe
does Councilor Marshall sit on that?
I'll call Derek.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Others? Thank you very much, Councilor Beatty, for your report.
Pleasure.
And we do have a motion to receive. It's been moved by Councillor Papp, seconded by Councillor Derulo, the report of Regional Councillor Beatty regarding the Regional Standing Committee meetings of October 22nd and 23rd, 2013, be received for information. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. Thank you very much, Councillor.
Mr. Mayor, I'll send out the clerk just to brief summary of the things I did for earlier.
That's excellent.
And in the future, I'll do that in advance of the meeting.
Thank you very much, Councillor. Appreciate that. And we shall see you at the region. Thank you. Been moved by Councillor Clark, seconded by Councillor Kersey, that the following minutes be adopted as printed, circulated, and read. Minutes of the regular meeting of Council of October 21st and of the special meeting of October 28th, 2013. All those in any errors or omissions? There being none, I call the question. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. The next item, Council will note that Councillor Beatty spoke about streamlining the agenda. We've now, through the adoption of our new procedure bylaw, have streamlined the agenda to include not only correspondence, but also action correspondence of a routine nature. Of course, any of these items can be lifted for separate consideration, that is, separate action.
Staff reports for for action or information.
And it includes staff reports for action or information. Thank you, Madam Clerk, regarding, in this case, it's the Pelham Seniors Advisory Committee terms of reference. So are there any items that councillors would like to lift for separate consideration that is separate action? There being none, it has been moved by Councillor Kersey, seconded by Councillor Durley, the following consent agenda items be received and approved as per the recommendations contained therein. The first, resolutions of the Policies and Priority Committee of October 21st, and the minutes of that particular meeting. That's the second item. The third is a staff report for action or information regarding the Pelham Seniors Advisory Committee terms of reference. The fourth, action correspondence of routine nature, which includes the Pelham Active Transportation Walk-Friendly Community designation, and also a proclamation request from the regarding Lung Month. The fifth information is information correspondence items. Thank you card from the Banshell Committee. Thank you card from the Big Move organizers. And the third is from the Niagara Regional Report regarding statutory public meeting for the fifth year review of the regional policy plan. The sixth broad area of that we'll be receiving and approving are committee minutes for information. They include the Communities in Bloom Committee of September 18th, the Pelham Active Transportation Committee of September 17th, and the Committee of Adjustment Minutes of October 1st. Questions, comments on any of those items? There being none. Oh, Councillor Papp, did you have something?
Mr. Mayor, are we going to be responding to any of the requests in the region about the five-year review of their regional policy plan? The staff?
Ms. Tafasoli?
Will you be responding to that?
We don't have any plan on that. If it's needed, we can work on
it. Okay, so as required, if there's something I presume that would be affecting us, we would have our input on it.
The distinction or the difference in the way that the region's attacking its overarching policy plan this time mm-hmm. is instead of doing an overall plan, it's actually taking sections and doing sections of the plan. So there's certain parts of the plan that would probably impact Pelham, and as they come up, it sounds like we'll respond.
So we'll respond accordingly as it affects the municipality.
Exactly.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Councillor, for the question. You. Others? Councillor Kersey.
Just a very brief question, Mr. Mayor, for clarity. When we make a proclamation declaring, you know, Lung Month or what have you, would we be doing more than one for any particular month, or would it be limited to one per month? And do we have a guideline on that with respect to that?
Same question. Madam Clerk.
I'm sorry I didn't bring the policy with me, but I don't think that there's any conflict between the one that's up now and the one that has been requested. Of course, it would be council's determination if we already had one, but there's no conflict between the two organizations, so we didn't enclose it, but we didn't see it as a problem.
So we currently have November listed as Philanthropy Month based on the presentation from the Niagara Community Foundation, and now this is requesting that it also be determined Lung Month.
So does that mean people give their lungs, or? Just a bad joke.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. Anything else on any of the reports? There being none, I call the question. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. Thank you. What's next here? Now I have to find my report. Next is my report. I had to follow along with this, as will members when they make reports. So a written report here, and hopefully this will mean that my report is very succinct. The first item there is regarding the Mayor's Youth Advisory Council. So as is outlined in the report, there's a new Mayor's Youth Advisory Council, 17 eager youth ready for another year of service. In some cases, there are four new members, which is excellent, as some have moved on. So again, a cross section of the community, and we appreciate each of those members. So we did have a meeting where we had icebreakers and reviewed a contract of commitment. The Constitution, and also talked about the executive positions. Those positions will be voted on November 12th, And then that will also include some of the committees. So council will know that members of the Mayor's Youth Advisory Council sit on a number of the town committees and have been very active in that. And that's when those will be elected and then presented at our next council meeting for adoption and inclusion in each of those committees. And then also the Mayor's Youth Advisory also works on short and long-term goals. And we started that process at our last meeting, and on November 12th, we will hope to set some of those goals. So that's regarding the Mayor's Youth Advisory Council. Also in the report, you'll note that the MYAC did host the first event, which was on October 25th, welcoming more than 200 skaters for the annual Halloween skate at the Pelham Arena. It's great to see that that vibrancy of folks dressed up in costume skating. And it was just a great event. Many thanks to Brian and Ann Durst from Brienne Farms for the continued support and donation of pumpkins for the pumpkin carving activity. And it was a great time had by all, and thanks to staff for assisting in organizing that and decorating up the arena for that event. Also, something we've continued from previous years is initiatives of the Local Government Week, and we continue to do that to help educate students about the role of local government. You'll see here that I attended along with the deputy clerk three schools and their grade 5 classes to talk about local government on October 24th and 5th, and they are Pelham Center School, St. Anne Catholic School, and St. Alexander Catholic School. And I understand that we're still continuing to try to touch base with E.L. Crosley to do something with the grade 10 students. In previous years, we've done mayor for the day elections, and we're going to try and do that again when the timing works for that school. And I wanted to thank on behalf of council the grade 5 teachers and the students for their warm reception as welcoming myself and the deputy clerk to talk about local government. It is part of their curriculum, and some of them had all the answers to the questions, so it was great to see. The next item is the volunteer community and well, the final item is the volunteer and community corporate recognition ceremony that Councillor Beatty spoke about. And of course, council was there, and it was our honor to present those awards, recognizing hundreds of volunteers in our community. A great presentation by Joe Veloce, an Olympian, and really a special guest. Very, very inspiring. And I think I'm going to say this: one of the best speakers that we've had at that event ever. He really tied in the message to volunteers. And showed how volunteers impacted his life specifically, and considering and suggesting that volunteers impact so many lives in so many ways. That particular individual with the at the track that's organized that really sort of spurring that on, and also with the Olympics and the number of volunteers there. So it was a great speech by Joseph, and we certainly wish him the best as he gets ready for the Pan Am Games. And also for the Olympics. We had special recognition for a peer award recipients. They are listed here. Again, great support in our community from a number of facets. Congratulations to each of them, and just wonderful to recognize them in that way. And also special recognition for the community corporate award recipient, Lazy Lean Restaurant and Perry Warden, and also his staff for the amount of fundraising that they do in the community. The feedback I've received from those awards, the peer awards, and I'm sure it's the same with council, is that the community really values that it is in keeping with our strategic plan. Somebody from a community like the Niagara Center Skating Club recognizes someone among them, and we honor them based on their nomination. So it's a great award that we started in 2009, and I really want to thank Perry Wachlich for designing and creating the 2013 award. It's an excellent award, and again, well received. And finally, special thanks to Taylor Wallace and Jessica Wilson, singers and songwriters, for their inspiration and entertainment at the event. It was just a very, very well done. So kudos to all. Finally, thank you very much to Ms. Van Ravensway for leading the charge with this, with staff and all of staff. So many staff volunteered their time that evening to help out and to be there and to organize it. And it really speaks to our community that, and perfect timing around the special, what's the day, what was the day called? The Random Act of Kindness Day. It wasn't random, but it was an act of kindness, certainly, that we held that award. So kudos to all, and thank you very much. So that's my report for members of council. for your submission. Next, we move to staff reports requiring action. Thank you. It's been moved by Councillor Kersey, seconded by Councillor Durley, that the issue sheet Christmas in Pelham be received, and that for reasons outlined in the report, Council designate Christmas in Pelham outdoor Christmas market municipally significant to be held under the arches on February, December 6th, with a rain date of Saturday, December 7th, 2013, and that the clerk be authorized to make application for a special occasion permit.
I think you said February, it's December.
Did I say February?
Mm-hmm.
It is December. Why did I say February? December 6th, I'm seeing Friday, December 6th, and Saturday, December 7th, and that the clerk be authorized to make application for a special occasion permit for Christmas in Pelham Outdoor Christmas Market, and further, the council authorized the following road closure. Pelham Town Square entrance off Pelham Street from 12 p.m. to 12 a.m. on Friday, December 6th, with a rain date of Saturday, December 7th. Thank you for catching that. I don't know where my head was thinking about that. Any discussion? Councillor Papp?
Well, I think that it's suffice to say that to the organizers, all of the people involved in this, this is the time for us to step forward to continue to demonstrate how we support our local businesses. The lineup here is incredible. It's just expanded. And as we go through all these discussions about economic development and how we're trying to encourage people to buy and participate locally, I couldn't think of a better time. I know, you know, it's Christmas, but the truth is, with everyone that's involved with all of this and the variety of things, I just hope that everybody in the general public hears this message and comes downtown. And we'll find you the parking, no matter what it takes. Even if they park in some people's front lawn. No, I can't do that, right, Bob? But in the meantime, it would like nothing better than to see it overwhelmed and come back and say that this is another part of our efforts to, not as a special event, but more important, not just that, it's part of our stimulus and encouraging business and local to take place. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you very much, Councillor Papp, for your comments. Others, Councillor Durley.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Further to that, that there's at least 21 events that are there, and Anna's done a terrific job in putting out this press release. We should circulate this in as many places as possible to make the awareness, just as Councillor Papp is saying, to nobody will have an excuse not knowing because we can put this up. So, in fact, if we can put this in local businesses, maybe with the cooperation of the PBA to have it everywhere so everybody will be aware of it, it'll be a terrific reminder. And we have Summerfest, maybe we make this a Shiver Fest or something like that, which would be good for the winter time. So how's that?
Thank you very much, Councillor. I'm going to call on Ms. Van Ravensway. I think she has a prop there that maybe she can hold up, and kudos to Ms. McKnight for organizing that. Ms. Van Ravensway?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This Very is just nice. A poster that was designed by Anna, and you'll see these pop up around town. It's basically, we have 2 months worth of activities that are going on, and we've tried to incorporate them all. And it's a very busy time of the year for everyone, and it's great being in Pelham and having so many wonderful things to do.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Ms. Van Ravensway. So there are some promotions linked with that, Councillor Durley, and we'll continue to put those up. I think that the key behind this is really council getting involved. It was so many events organized in the community, things like the parade and food drive, etc., and then the PBA stepped forward under various leadership from members of the community coming forward to organize something officially, and now with the town's involvement, it's sort of putting it into a neat package that Councillor Papp spoke about. So, and you know, there was always this vision. I think we got a little bit late last year, and this year we're ahead of the game, and in future years as well. So it's great to get this information out. That the art studio tour is on, and the Home for the Holidays house tour, and all of the various things. So the first is this Wednesday, the Holiday Gift Showcase and Downtown Stroll, which is November 6th, and which is a great event. And I actually know a lot of staff attend that, and council attends that as well. So thank you very much for staff for working together with the community to pull this together. And we look forward to a wonderful Christmas season. Councillor Papp, you want to add?
Quickly through you to Vicky. Vicky, and Anna, are those going to be sizes of those? That's going to be of different size signage, you know, different placement? Maybe I'm not.
Yes, Rita, at the moment we have these going out for
right.
around town, as well as we're having cards. Because we go on, we have 2 months basically that we have to cover. We're having rack cards developed, so November's on the first, you know, yeah. the front side, and December's on the second side. So, you know, it's 2 months worth basically.
Could you send this? Have you sent this to the Welland Pelham Chamber as well to broadcast this? Could you send it over to the Welland Pelham Chamber?
Through you, Mayor. The press release gets circulated to everyone within the community. If you would like the poster forward to them, we can do that by all
yeah.
means.
It's joint partner, yeah. Good promotion. Thank you.
Thank you. And I think that just for council's information, some of the events obviously they're not all put on by the town. In fact, most of them aren't. It's just
right.
this one event.
Yeah.
But many of those event organizers have other marketing that they do, so it's a way of tying it all together.
Perfect.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So we look forward to that. And Ms. Van Ravensway?
I was just going to note that the chamber also sits on the committee.
Yeah.
So the chamber and the PBA.
Just
so
push it out everywhere you can.
Good.
Spread the word.
Winterfest.
Winter.
Oh, no.
Shiverfest.
Shiverfest.
I don't know what Shiverfest.
I like the Shiverfest better.
I guess, Ms. Van Ravensway, this is the start. So will there be a report at the end in the new year, a debriefing? Okay, good. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. Anything further? I'm going to call the question. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion's carried. And we look forward to Christmas in Pelham starting this Wednesday. And continuing all the way until January 5th with that free skate by Tim Hortons. And this event, which is something a bit new for us, which is the Outdoor Christmas Market on Friday, December 6th. You didn't say snow date, so just rain date. I look forward to that. So thank you, Council. Now to the next item, which is the execution of a site plan agreement. It's been moved by Councilor Ribiak, seconded by Councilor Kersey, that for reasons outlined in the issue sheet regarding the Sawmill Golf Limited, Council consider approving the site plan agreement SP0613 for the Sawmill Golf Practice Facility located at 2610 Maple Street, and the Council refund $2,500 of the town's $3,500 administration fee for site plan control, and further that Council approve the required zoning bylaw as presented later in this evening's meeting, authorizing the Mayor and Clerk to sign a site plan agreement between the Town of Pelham and Sawmill Golf Limited. Mm-hmm. I see that some of the one of the owners is here and an agent of the owner. Any comments, questions from members of Council? This is closing the loop on this, and certainly the as was requested, as is in the issue sheet, was requested by Sawmill Golf, some relief given on the site plan control. I'm pleased to see that it's here. Are we ready for the question? Mm-hmm. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. Thank you for that. Thank you. Unfinished business. It has been moved by Councillor King, seconded by Councillor Ribiak, that Council receive Regional Report PHD 05-2013 revised, seeking endorsement of the enactment of Regional Bylaw 112-2013, being a regional bylaw to protect children and vulnerable citizens from exposure to outdoor secondhand smoke, and that Council for the Town of Pelham does hereby give its consent to the proposed bylaw in recognition of the triple majority component required for the bylaw to come into force, and that the clerk be directed to advise the regional clerk of this endorsement. Discussion regarding this issue? Councillor Durley.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. As I brought up at the onset when this first came to this table, I have a problem in accepting this, because and as mentioned at the last meeting that this was brought up, we've had the banned shell activities here for several years, and there's been outdoor smoking. We have never ever heard a complaint about any of this happening. Smokers are in the minority. I'm not a smoker, and I don't profess that smoking is a good thing, and I don't profess that people should smoke, but it's still legal. I can go into any store and buy a package of cigarettes legally, and I can smoke it legally. So in all fairness to smokers, and they like I said before, they are in a minority, and they tend to be a little more courteous now than they used to be. So, you know, I don't really think that a prohibition on that is truly the answer. It's Big Brother watching you, and it just strikes a nerve with me a little bit. And like I say, I'm not professing people should smoke, and I'm not saying that people should blow smoke in other people's faces. What I'm saying is that their tax money paid for the park. Their tax money, they work hard for their money, they're paying taxes on the cigarettes. Cigarettes are legal. If in fact smoking should be banned in the Niagara region, it should be banned all across the province of Ontario or perhaps the country of Canada. I think we're being specific there. It is not the proper way to go. Just my thoughts.
Okay, thank you very much, Councillor. Others? I do want to tell Council as a point of information or fact that the motion as is presented has been revised. So there has been some changes from what we've seen, and I just want to highlight that for the public as well. There were some concerns expressed by this council and other councils about roadways and parking lots and things like that. So that was actually excluded and is specifically exempted, that smoking can continue in those areas except for a 9-meter radius or something around the entrance or exit to a building, etc. So that was one of the changes. The other was clarity regarding who is going to enforce the bylaw. This council, I know for sure, requested that the region enforce it, and that our bylaw officers would not be enforcing this. And that is in the bylaw that it's done by the tobacco control officers. And I think those are the major changes to the bylaw. Some other small changes as well. So that's as a point of information. This was approved by a clear majority at Regional Council when it came to us. I'm going to keep talking here. I am supportive of the bylaw. I think it places that happy medium in terms of what people are. Some concerns that have been expressed to me. I have received some complaints from folks, for example, at the band shell or at some of our parks, concerned with people smoking. I think this is a good balance, and it would be across the entire region. The final point of information, we did hear that some municipalities like Niagara Falls have a stronger outdoor control smoking bylaw, and that is also allowed under this, that a municipality, should it choose, can enact stronger regulations. So any other comments from councillors? Are we ready for the question? All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. Thank you. The next item is that additional item that Councillor Clark has added. Councillor Clark.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have an opportunity to relocate in British Columbia and will be moving there in a few months. As a member of this council, in order to provide better continuity with upcoming issues and moving them forward, I feel that is in the best interest of the town of Pelham that I resign my seat in Ward 1, effective Tuesday, November 5th, 2013, and I have presented my letter to the clerk. The last 3 years as a councillor for the town of Pelham have been very interesting for me, and I am proud of the accomplishments and changes that this council has made. I have a much greater appreciation for politicians at this level because the view is very different from this side of the desk. Looking ahead, I feel we have a strong council and staff team here in Pelham and have confidence that they will continue to move the business of the town of Pelham forward. My family and I have lived in Pelham since 1989, and is a great community for our children to grow up in, and we have enjoyed living here.
Thank you very much, Councillor, for your letter and for your announcement. I'm going to speak first, and then I'm going to invite other councillors to speak. I think we receive your resignation with regret. We understand that it is your decision in terms of moving to British Columbia. And we'll certainly miss you around this council table. You have shown that you're a good councillor. You're concerned about our community. You're concerned about the interests specifically in your ward and other wards as well. You've shown that you brought forward the interests of residents and the business community to this table at every meeting and continue to follow up on their concerns. So if you bring an issue here, you show that you continue to follow up with it until that issue is resolved. You've also provided a common sense voice during much of our discussion and debate through the 3 years of your representation and service. You've also, Councillor, continued to challenge each of us to think hard about any spending that we do because of the taxpayers' hard-earned money, and you've been very cognizant of that. And the final, I guess, is that you've also been very committed to improving the community, and we saw this in your service as president of the Pelham Business Association, and you continued that service here. So I want to thank you very much for your service, and say that I will miss you, and I know council colleagues will miss you sitting in that chair and serving your community. So thank you very much for your service.
Thank you.
I wonder if other members have any comments they'd like to make regarding Councillor Clark's resignation. Councillor Ribiak and then King, apparently.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I did second the motion to add this to the agenda, and I did so with regret. I think we should note that not only are we losing a committed, dedicated member of our council, the community is losing an extremely important element in its makeup. I can't tell you how often people have said to me, Larry Clark built my house. And I think that anybody who can create a legacy in which his name is synonymous with quality and integrity is really leaving something substantial behind. So it's with great regret that I see Mr. Clark leaving our council.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor King.
Mr. Mayor. Larry, I would honestly say that I will miss you a great deal because I've thoroughly appreciated your enthusiastic approach to some very hot issues at times and the emotion that you've put into expressing your thoughts and supporting your, what will I call them, the residents within your ward and representing them. I've learned a great deal from you, and I will miss you here at this table. But I wish you all the best in BC. It's a great spot. I have stepchildren there myself, as we've discussed, so. Have a wonderful time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Councillor Clark, we didn't always agree, but we always left the argument in this room and were able to carry on a social networking that was valuable to me. I hope it was to you as well. I made a good friend in you. I hope that continues to be a good friend. Keep in touch, and all the best of luck to you and your family in BC.
Okay, thank you very much, John.
Larry, when I first got the call to meet with you, I honestly thought you were pulling a joke on me. As I sat there and I wondered, what was this all about? And then when you told me this, quite honestly, I was taken aback. I remember, and many of you don't know, that before Larry decided to embark on a political campaign, him and I had a little sit down and we talked about what was involved and what everything, and everything I told him, he said, you lied to me. The truth was that he was successful, and he understood the, and just as many of you said, that there's a he became obviously a very, very highly visible and very dedicated to the interests of his ward. But more importantly, he also understood the interests of the community. You didn't stop when you thought that you had something to say, and you believed in that belief, and you stated it. And as Councillor Durley has said too, we didn't always agree, but what was most important about that is we left it there, and we all together set aside our differences and personal differences with that. This is not an easy game, as you probably know, for Councillor Durley and I, and I know the mayor. Councillor Durley and I have been here almost a decade, and we've spent our time in public service. And people don't realize, or I hope they understand, that when you run for elected office, you do it surely not for the money. I know that for a fact. You surely don't do it for downtime, but you are exposed to every possible thing from very simple issues to those that are very complex. And local government has become that. You have clearly demonstrated to all of us, and particularly myself, I'm so proud of you and how you've handled everything. And quite honestly, as I said it before to you, it's almost like you've been a brother to me, and I hope I've been a brother to you.
I'm like a father.
And that's true. I could be a father to you. When you leave here, I encourage you, and I say this, I hopefully, with all of you, you don't just stop thinking about what you did here, that hopefully you'll continue your municipal career as a politician in Kelowna. That you seriously consider that, because I think you've earned the skills and the respect and the knowledge to be able to apply that. And don't ever forget that. The impact you had here was significant, whether you believe it or not. You've all of us feel very comfortable in talking with each other and yourself. And I know that from the bottom of my heart to your family, to all of you, and as you depart, it'll be a sad day. But as I say, the Italians say, it's arrivederci till we meet again. And I'm sure that that'll happen, because I think we can do a road trip to Kelowna, can't we, Madam Treasurer, or something? I'll fly the plane. No, I can't fly yet. And I'm really, really going to miss you, Larry, and I hope you'll continue to do that and stay in touch, and I know we'll be in touch with you. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councilor.
Well, Larry, one of the disadvantages of being the last guy to talk is there ain't a whole lot left to say. And that's a first for me at this council table.
Note that down.
Mark that. Did you get that?
Noted. Noted in the minutes.
Anyway, Larry, you and I have not always agreed at this table, but like the rest of my colleagues, I certainly have come to appreciate you as a person first and foremost, as a man dedicated to his community, as a man passionate about his views and his undertakings. Yeah. And my colleagues have focused on the fact that we'll all be disappointed and sad to see you leave and to lose your intellect and your passion and your dedication. I'm going to focus on your future. As I said to you the other day, very few of us get the opportunity to fulfill a dream, a lifetime dream.
That's true.
And you are having the opportunity to fulfill a lifetime dream. And so with that, I wish you all the best, Godspeed, and hope to see you again.
Okay, thank you.
I do appreciate Councillor Durley's suggestion that we remain in contact. I know I'm going to miss some of those conversations that we have. Dave, call me in five about an issue. And so I do hope that we will stay in contact. And I like the idea also of not a road trip, but a flight out there from the...
Well,
so, Peter, get your
lessons.
Flying lessons at the airport.
That's
and let's,
right.
We can
let's go visit him out there.
That's right. We can parachute right in.
Because
you'll be backpacking.
Clark, when he went out there, he came back with some information from Kelowna and was suggesting that some of the things that they do there might be good for our municipality. So we know that your heart is here as well, and if there's other great ideas that are out there, we hope you can pass it along to us. But we, again, will certainly miss you and look forward to keeping in contact with you.
Okay. Yeah.
Councillor Durley?
Perhaps Councillor Clark can be an ambassador and we can maybe look at Twin Cities.
Here we go.
Bellamy.
Good idea. Good idea, Councillor.
Oh, your brother, Matt.
No, I still have family here, so I will be back from time to time. So I will stop in.
Excellent.
Okay.
Thank you very much. So we do have a motion, and there's no mover and seconder here. That we receive the letter of resignation dated November 4th, 2013, submitted by Ward 1 Councillor Larry Clark, that it be received and accepted with regret. and then on to the future of this council, that the clerk be directed to prepare a report for consideration at the November 18th, 2013 meeting of the Policy and Priorities Committee, outlining options available to the corporation to fill the vacancy created by this resignation. So can I have a mover and a seconder? The move by Councillor Papp, seconded by Councillor Ribiak. Madam Clerk, can you just speak to the requirement of the Act as well as we move forward? So just let Council and the community know about not only this report, but a next step at Council.
Yes, through you, Mr. Mayor. The November 18th meeting of Council, the Municipal Act will require that we actually officially declare the seat vacant, so there will be a motion placed on the agenda for November 18th to declare that seat vacant, and then at committee, unless Council chooses to amend and consider the report at Council, but at Policy and Priorities Committee, we would consider the report that will outline options for Council to fill the seat, to fill the vacancy for the rest of the term.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that. Okay. Thank you again. I'm going to call the question. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried with regret. Thank you. Presentation and consideration of bylaws. It's been moved by Councillor King, seconded by Councillor Ribiak, the Council of the Town of Pelham, having given due consideration the following bylaw, be now read a first, second, and third time and passed the same, and that the mayor and clerk are hereby authorized to sign and seal the bylaw. Bylaw 3433, 2013, being a bylaw to authorize the mayor and clerk to enter into a site plan agreement with Sawmill Golf Limited. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. And I see Mr. Julie is here. Thank you, Mr. Julie, for being here, and good luck in the installation of that that driving range. Thank you. Members of Council, we do have some in-camera items, and as we generally do, we put them off until after committee. So I do have a motion that's been moved by Councillor Durley, seconded by Councillor King. The Council recessed the in-camera portion of the meeting and reconvene immediately following the committee of the whole meeting scheduled for later this evening. All those in favor? Any opposed? That motion is carried. We'll now take a brief recess before we start committee of the whole. Thank you. Charter.